Affirmative action began as riot control. Harlem was up in flames. Bed-Stuy was up in flames. Newark was up in flames. And if we don't do something to bring in young black people to the mainstream economically and educationally, we're not sure the society will hold together. The words affirmative action initially were attempts to deal with discrimination that African Americans faced in the labor market. There were executive orders by President Kennedy and President Johnson which said employers had to make a good faith effort to use affirmative action in their hiring and recruitment policies, which meant they were going to try to recruit people who had once been discriminated against.
I have some very sad news for all of you, and that is that Martin Luther King was shot and was killed tonight in Memphis.
After the assassination of Dr. King, there were riots in 60 American cities simultaneously. The leaders of the society, whether they were in government, business, or academia, said, this society can't hold together if black people are burning the cities. And they're burning the cities because they feel excluded. So we've got to bring them into our workplace. We got to bring them into our educational institutions. We got to let them feel that they have a stake in the society. It was a very effective response to urban unrest. Hundreds of thousands of people being hired by major corporations who wouldn't have been hired. You had colleges admitting large numbers of black students who previously only admitted a handful. It really changed the country. But it wasn't done because of a sudden burst of conscience. It was done out of fear that the society was falling apart. And when the fear passed, the sense of urgency about recruiting those large numbers of people started to dissipate as well.